to center court. Jose Luis Clerc putting on quite a show here against a red-hot Andres Gomez. Clerc with the break, leading 4-3. And Roscoe, we'll see if Clerc continues to serve as well as he has been. And is Gomez going to do a little something different on the return?
Yeah, he's got to make some adjustments right now. And I think you've seen Andres try to make adjustments on his own serve. But he's got to do something. He's standing way, way back there to receive. You know, and actually, he got a little fun. Now in the second serve, he moves up closer.
Here he comes. Oh, he faked it.
Oh, it worked, though. The fake made Clerc look up.
Oh, sure did. Gomez looked like he was coming in behind that.
Yeah, I would have said he's going in when he hits it.
Wow,
that's a pretty good fake.
You're telling me. Wow.
That means they went on the changeover. He's thinking about it. I got to do something a little different.
And suddenly here, Gomez with a big chance. Love 30. Andres is interesting, you know, in his quiet way. He's always thinking and doing something a little different out there. Oh, too good.
And he didn't hit that quite as solid as he wanted to, but it was good enough. And the whole thing is, all along with that backhand, when somebody's coming on, he's hit it cross court. He's hit that same shot, and it works every time. But now he's got his own set of triple break points.
Drop shot. Oh, that's perfect. What a great get from Gomez. Somehow gets that lob over Clerc.
Was one fantastic get, and both of them had tried little angle drop shots off this before. There he hits the lob. Clerc was right on top of the net to cover that. Look at this, he's ready for the next ball. And they were trying to say earlier in the week that maybe he's not keyed up about this match. These guys are ready.
Oh, perfect shot. So Gomez breaks. We are at four games off. First set, this is best of three for the championship, and $100,000 here, the Nuveen Masters playoff. Around to get out of the way of that ball, but hits him behind the baseline, he loses the point.
He still loses it, that's right. That ball was blowing around too. I think it shocked him a little bit.
Gomez out wide, his second ace of the day.
And that's textbook perfect. I mean, he's broken serve, and the first thing he does is he comes back and puts in two first serves. You know, nice and solid. They weren't necessarily right next to the line, but they were hard.
So Gomez, as Clerc checks the sky, suddenly, Roscoe, the conditions have changed drastically. It was sunny and bright, warm. Now it's cooling off. A lot more wind.
Gomez has won 7 points in a row. Make that eight.
We'll go wide, and so Gomez holds it lovely. Andres Gomez right back in the driver's seat, leading 5-4 in the first set. Stay with us. We're at the Nuveen Masters, Naples, Florida. Wind coming right from the side there.
Yeah, they're flying sideways today.
These conditions, very difficult. They change drastically, virtually after every point. Back to center court, 5-4 now. Gomez leading, Clerc trying to serve, holds up new tennis balls. This will definitely help the server.
Yeah, he's going to be going with the big ones. It'll be interesting to see if he sticks to his pattern, goes out wide in the beginning of the game, but then as the game gets tighter and tighter, more up the middle. Oh, he changed his pattern.
Just wide.
The guy that's going to win is the guy with the best attitude on these types of things. Look at this, Eric. Oh, no, I got to go back. Oh, let's get back to it. And he makes it.
Over the shoulder shot right down the line. this first set as Clerc drills that forehand up the line.
Yeah, he's just playing so solid there. He's really getting his concentration down. After making another shot, his attitude's bound to have had a huge lift.
Oh, double fault. Second double of the day.
That ball just got into the wind and wouldn't come down for him. And there it was, going for the middle again on the big point.
Goes long, and so a 30-love lead disappears. Suddenly Gomez now, 2 points away from this set.
It's been interesting how both guys will get up 30-love on their serve, and then they'll go into a little bit of a drift.
Yeah.
I mean, a double fault at 30-love is one of the big mistakes. You don't want to at least make the other guy win the point.
Hit. There is Ana Maria Gomez. Her husband can win this point. It is set point for the first set. Big opportunity here for Gomez, second serve. Set here at the Nuveen Masters Final, 6-4, Gomez. This tour is brought to you by John Nuveen and Company, providing quality tax-free investments since 1898. By Focuseal, the world's finest adhesive and sealant systems. By Corel Corporation, the world leader in graphics and CD-ROM technology. And by Citibank, the city never sleeps. Well, in the second set, Gomez looked like he was going to win this thing in straight sets. He was up 4-1, but Clerc came roaring back with some big serving to win it in a tiebreak, 7-6. Now, it's final set, 3-1 for Gomez. He has the break. Clerc in trouble. Is Hernan Suarez, who came out and warmed up with Clerc before this match, traveling with him, some coaching. Question is he coaching during the match?
That's the question a lot of guys have been asking. So far, it seems like he's not really coaching anything technical, just kind of giving him some encouragement.
Suddenly, Clerc going astray, overhitting the forehand. Love 15.
Well, and what has been one of Clerc's problems over the last couple of years on this tour is when he's lost, he hits two or three hard balls, and if you get him back with pretty good pace, then he'll miss the fourth one. That's just what's starting to happen right now. But generally, he can bring himself out just like he's doing right now, and he did it yesterday with Creek by coming in with a big serve. He's down a break right now, and he can't afford to get behind another one. Two breaks would be death.
Sure looked a little long. Now Andres is going to show a mark here if he can find it.
That's exactly where it hit, right where he's pointing. But you don't talk to the linesman in this thing. You're supposed to talk to the guy in the chair.
Clerc is already lined up on the other side. There is the service lineswoman who
the rules are right now that the umpire is supposed to come out of the chair, not the linesman.
There goes the mark, if there was one. Is Gomez just shuffles it with his foot. Roger White in the chair is yet to move out of that chair.
They made some adjustments last night after what went on yesterday. You know, that's a big possibility that the umpires discussed it and they said, no, we're not getting out of the chair anymore.
Could be, because it sure happened a lot yesterday.
Oh, geez, it was a bunch yesterday. But it's definitely being handled differently today than yesterday.
That was wide. Second serve now. 30 all. Oh, Gomez missing with an easy return on the back end. Gomez has a break, Roscoe. This match is far from over.
Yes, and I just noticed also that now Gomez is up a break. His wife has returned. So things are going okay again, but it is tight. I mean, anything can happen at any moment. There she is, Anna Maria.
Gomez to serve, leading 3-2 with a break. Final set. And he opens up with an excellent serve out wide, right on the sideline. I don't know why Clerc would look at that ball. That was clearly...
That ball touched the line.
Yep. Now for the first time, Roger White being called out of the chair.
The ball...
Sure. Ball was good.
Sure was good.
Yeah, right on the ball. It looked good. We were... Good view from up here. Another look at it, Roscoe.
It's amazing to me. To me, that ball clearly hit off the line. I don't... And the umpire has said good. What's the discussion about?
I don't know. Once, to me, Roger, right there, the umpire should have said, hey, it was good, back in the chair, and it's over.
Let's go.
Yeah.
I don't understand why he got out of the chair that time and wouldn't get out of the chair the other time. I'm not quite sure I get it.
Dean Love. Played by Gomez, not an easy shot.
Well, he's moving the ball around again, you know, and he's actually concentrating and focusing on each shot that he has to hit. So he's gotten back in position. We'll see if he can hold this concentration all the way through to the end of the set. It faltered on him at the end of the second set, and he got close to winning.
Want to see what it looks like from about 1,500 feet above this court. Gomez serving just wide. Up in the blimp, this is what it looks like. Second serve. Mylon will go wide.
Yeah, that ball got up there, and the wind, no way the wind was letting that thing come down for a while.
I thought maybe somebody was going to reach out from the blimp and grab that ball just then. That would have been a shot. There is our perch right behind us. It's good. Look out, it's good. A well-disguised lob from Andres Gomez and from way above this court. About a blockbuster view. Fantastic.
That was
running
awesome
for him.
That was perfect. Watch Gomez is really moving around. He hits this ball pretty short. So Clerc has to come in behind it. But there's that top spin lob. And you got that boy. When you're hitting that shot against the wind, too, you can really rifle it into the wind, and the wind catches it, and then the top spin brings it down. It's a very, very big shot to hit. A great shot to hit at that particular moment.
We have arrived at the famous seventh game of the set. 4-2, Gomez up, Clerc with a must game coming up here.
15
left. It's the same situation Gomez was in the second set.
No, the forehand goes long.
15 all.
I think suddenly Gomez, much more consistent, Roscoe, back in this set, keeping balls in play.
Yeah, he's thinking about what he's got to do again. He's gotten back to where he's involved in the match. The problem is that he let Clerc get back into the match, too. Before all that happened in the second set, when he lost his composure, Clerc was not in it.
Clerc playing strongly now, serving seventh ace, and now leads 40-50. A big hand. Nobody's left. We are center court. Levine Masters, the winner, will walk away with 100,000. 4-3 Gomez, final.
Pressed. Then it goes the other way around. It's been incredible.
A lot of emotion from both players, and this match is far from over. Both players getting a big hand as they crossed over, and so now Gomez serving 4-3 up with a break in the final set.
To him hit the ball, it sounds like a boxer out there going every time he hits the ball, and he's hitting it as hard as he can. I mean, he's launching himself into the ball, and I mean, there's nothing left on the table from Jose Luis Clerc in this match.
Love 15. We'll go long. Gomez back with an excellent first serve, deep to the backhand.
And both these guys, every time they've been down, they've come up with big serves to get them out of it.
See,
the rules are that Gomez has to stop. If Gomez does not stop right there, watch this. As soon as that ball hits, Gomez stops. He has to show that he stopped, because the rules are if he played that ball, he can't complain.
Exactly. Wow.
So it's really an amazing thing. See, he has to now show that he's not playing that ball.
Yeah, he immediately goes to the mark.
Yeah,
he's not about ready to give that point away.
But if the umpire says, no, you played it, then he can't complain. It's a sort of an odd rule.
Big point, too. 15 all. Now Gomez up 30-15. Oh.
He gets it right back. I mean, that was not a difficult shot. He's right there. He's been making that shot all his life. But here we go now. It's 30 all. It's a big point. And there you see.
And Gomez now.
Yeah, well, he looks over and he sees Clerc taking extra time, so he goes, oh, heck with it, I'm going to go take some more time. He hardly touched the towel. that taking that extra time that Clerc's doing is getting through these guys.
Oh, Gomez looking over, waiting for Clerc. No. Double fault as he goes for a big second serve, his fifth double of the day.
Now here's what's interesting. See, Clerc didn't even touch a ball in that point.
Yeah.
So now he's
going to
towel off again. It's interesting. There is Anna Marie Gomez. She's back. Maybe going again. But she's back here. But it's interesting to me. Why do you have to go towel off? He didn't even touch a ball.
Chance now for Clerc to get right back in this final set. Break point. Ooh, that court serve. That first serve.
3 up in the third set, break point down, $100,000 on the line, and he goes for a drop volley, first volley.
Great racket work by Gomez there. Beautiful touch. John McEnroe would have liked that little drop volley.
That's the other guy that would have done that shot.
Stop the point. See, that ball looked like it maybe hit inside the line. But here, he's got it. I mean, this is his favorite shot.
Oh, what a big point. And once again, Clerc with a chance.
Here we'll see it again. Is this ball long? I think it looks like it maybe caught the line.
Yeah. But look at this shot. A wide open court. Gomez mishits the ball way over the baseline. And so Clerc now with a chance to get to four all.
Didn't hit it. Looked to me like he was standing right there. Watch this ball.
Yeah. Could have volleyed it, Roscoe.
Wow. He was right there.
And Clerc, look at this guy.
You know,
right back in the set.
The way Clerc is pumping his fist in the air reminds me a little bit of one of the players we have in this tournament in the U.S. Open a couple of years ago. Jimmy Connors in some of those matches that got to the semifinal. It was just about as emotional as Clerc.
Exactly. Have a brand new ball game, four games apiece. Final set, Clerc to serve. Boy, talk about an up and down emotional match.
Yeah, another emotional swap here. Amazing.
New tennis balls, Roscoe, late in the final set. That will help him.
That's going to help a lot. And because they also, he's the one that's been a little bit more aggressive. And when you're a little more aggressive, you can do a lot with a light, with a new ball. It's a little lighter. It's going to fly a little faster. The fuzz on it's a little more compact.
Played a total of 31 games. Ball changed at 9 and 11. No, that's going to go wide.
No, that's just an example. That's a new ball.
Yeah.
When that ball hit, it bounced up a little bit higher, a little bit faster.
Yeah.
Also, the guys are a little bit tired, so they're going to be a little bit late. He was definitely late on that backhand.
So Clerc now taking extra time. 30 love. Goes for the ace down the middle. It's wide. No, miss hit from Gomez, and so quickly now, Clerc at 40 love.
Watch Clerc, I mean, he's just amazing back there. I was sitting there staring at him as he's in between points. I mean, after he left, he's closing his eyes. It's like he's going, please. I mean, he wants this more than anything.
For Clerc, when we return, Gomez will serve to try and stay in this match. Jose Luis Clerc leading 5-4. Another look at that last point from the blockbuster video blimp. Roscoe, talk about emotion. Watch Clerc on the right.
And he has a great approach out there to come in. His volley was not quite far enough over. He had a chance for that ball to go in, but it goes long. Watch Clerc. Throws a ball in the air. He's jumping around. He thinks it's carnival.
You talk about Jimmy Connors. He is really fired up.
I tell you what, if Clerc wins this game and wins this match and the Nuveen Masters champion, I mean, he's liable to jump out of the stadium.
Out of his skin. Jose Luis Clerc, a big hand again for both players. This crowd has been treated to a tremendously competitive match here this afternoon. As Gomez gets ready to serve to try and get even at 5 games all.
Clerc taking a little extra time. See that? He's holding him up, stopping him, looking down.
No question about that ball.
Well, and there you saw Andres Gomez just said to himself, hey, you can do anything you want, slow me down, whatever you want. I'm going to put my first serve in, and I'm going to use my forehand, and I'm going to get back to doing the things that I know how to do.
15, love.
Right after Jose missed that ball, he's flipping his hand around like saying, hit it, come on, hit it. And that's what you got to do. You got to force yourself almost to be brave and to be fearless and go for it. That's what Jimmy Connors was talking about in one of his tips. Go for it. When you're on the edge of winning, win it.
It's going to be short. Good. No call. No call on that sideline. Clerc thought it was out.
Well, you know what happened? When it flew over Jose's head, it was out. But as it came down, the wind caught it and blew it around. And I think it actually caught partly on the sideline.
You could see that ball. It was like a screwball going through the air. Now Clerc asking Roger White in the chair.
Yeah, and while I'm sitting here, our viewpoint is more or less right on the line. Now he kills this ball. This ball, as it's coming around him, it's out, but it landed, it kind of curved around and landed more or less on the sideline.
Yeah. As easily with the forehand, and now 40 love. Short ball again. No call. And now, Roger White asking for a replay.
He called out. There's a safe signal. Baseline's umpire called out.
Let's listen.
Now the baselines, they're saying the baselines person called out, but then called good.
Right now, please, okay? Try to be professional, okay? We spent too many hours over here, okay?
Another look at that ball. It looked like it was behind the baseline. No call.
Well,
Clerc.
Yeah, what happened was the girl over there that's calling, or the lady that's calling the baseline, made a flinch and said out, and then said good.
Yeah.
And thing was, he hit an unbelievable shot. It's unfortunate to have something like that happen. You know what the interesting thing was in that point? I was watching Andres Gomez's foot to see about a foot fault. Now she could call a foot fault and really get involved. And he did move his foot again and actually nudged up against the line. Yes. So he has foot faulted a couple times where they have not called it.
He is really close on that baseline, Roscoe. You're so right. Look at that.
And his foot is moving.
Yeah. Oh, that's going to go wide. And so Gomez holds the crucial 10th game of the final set. 5 games all after all this time. Believe it or not, Jose Luis Clerc coming back from a 4-1 deficit in the second set to even this match. Suddenly, 5 games all, final set, championship at stake, and $100,000. That is a superb cross-court backhand.
To be able to hit that ball by Clerc from as far back as he was from the line, I mean, the angle that he got on that ball and the pace.
And against the wind.
And against the wind. It's incredible.
Well, 15. Clerc right down the center. It's ninth ace of the day.
You know, Clerc has done that so many times down the middle. You begin to wonder, why doesn't Andres just go ahead and stand over there and see if Clerc can hit the other side?
Exactly. The big first serve.
30-50.
get the sense this crowd is behind Clerc a bit more than Gomez right now?
Well, you know, because Andres is a quiet guy. He doesn't show a lot of emotion. He's got a lot inside, I can tell you that for sure. But Clerc is a crowd sort of a guy.
Yeah. Another big serve by Clerc down the center. So from love 15 down, Jose Luis Clerc, 1 point away from a 6-5 lead. Jose Luis Clerc, unbelievable story, coming back from 4-1 down in the second set. A lot of people, when this match started, were wondering how quickly Gomez could win. Clerc, the eighth player to get in this championship, and Gomez on a roll, beating both Connors and McEnroe, and suddenly, Jose Luis Clerc, one game away from the title and $100,000. What a story, Roscoe.
It's amazing. I mean, he was out. He was finished. But then, right at the right moment, or the wrong moment as far as Gomez is concerned, it looked to me like he started thinking about winning, and he stopped hitting the ball. And then some things happened, and doubt crept into his game. He got mad, he got upset, he lost his concentration, and everything. It, now, anything can happen.
Gomez serving now, 5-6 down, trying to get into a tiebreak. Clerc would love to break and win the title right here. Yes, too good.
I don't know about you, Barry, but I actually feel like Clerc is a little favored right now.
Yeah.
I mean, I would tend to pick him to win this match.
He looks a little more alert. He looks a little more charged up.
Yeah.
More competitive right now.
But by everything we've seen, it can change in about 2 seconds. Amazing match.
Oh, yes. Clerc just pulls that forehand cross court. Great control on the topspin.
And you can see him after he hit that shot. You know, watch his emotion. He hits it right here. I mean, it's a great shot. Just barely clears the net. But he turns around and he's going, oh, please, give me three more of those.
15 all. No call. Like it might have been wide. Jose having another look.
Part of it was wide.
Gomez with his eighth ace of the day, and what a time for it. Puts him up 30-15. Gomez brings up the backhand, Roscoe, overhits what looked to be a fairly routine approach shot.
You know, and what it does is all these errors like this are just giving an opportunity where Jose Luis Clerc might be able to win this match with one shot. I mean, he didn't hit a great return there. He just got the ball back.
2 points away now. 30 off. No fault. Championship point.
You watch, after all that's going on, Clerc is going to hit one big shot and he could win the whole thing. It's amazing to me. It's just Gomez has given him an opening. Time after time.
Taking a lot of extra time.
Missed that ball. He looked over to his coach like going, oh, and the coach is going, that's okay, you did the right thing, you did the right thing. So if that's the signals they're worried about, that's not too bad.
Okay, Hernan Suarez
almost out of nails there.
It's deuce. Yes, Gomez, number 9, right down the center. Now Gomez, 1 point away from the tiebreak. long.
this is unbelievable.
He does. Oh, the backhand goes long, and so once again, Gomez stays alive.
I just have a feeling that both players sense how important these points are right now, and they're both tense. They're both tight. Swinging freely.
Will be decided by a tiebreaker.
Hey, this match is going with all the emotions going back and forth. It should be a tiebreaker that decides.
Right. What a match. Six games, all Clerc to serve. Trying to stay loose. Six games, all final set. Jose Luis Clerc serving in the first point of the tiebreaker. Get a little low, Roscoe, I thought.
Yeah, you know, it looked like to me he's been chipping that ball quite a bit, and he's been wanting to hit it, and he couldn't quite make up his mind to do it. So he kind of, instead of taking a couple of steps to get to that ball and bending down low, he took a long step and kind of leaned over, and this was a little out of balance. That's why, I mean, you know, he had that match point, he wanted to hit a winner, he didn't, and it's still been mulling it over in his mind. He's got to get it out of there for this tiebreaker.
1-0, Gomez. First player to reach 7 points with a 2-point lead will win this title. Solid first serve from Gomez, 2-0.
You get the feeling if Gomez gets up a 3-0, that he's, I mean, he is in a big commanding lead, but it's only one service break, but then Clerc has to win both his. Must.
Ooh, that's a big serve. Gomez right down the center.
Where Clerc is in a must-win situation on these 2 points, otherwise he's down bad. That's a great serve.
Clerc barely getting his racket on it.
Quiet, please.
Certainly, it's a tiebreaker, but the hole is pretty deep.
That is solid tennis from Clerc. Difficult shot. The ball moved about 20 feet.
4-1.
Oh, as if we haven't had enough distractions. Now we have a bird that has flown in and landed in the service box. There we go. Decided just wanted to check on things, see how everybody was.
4-1, Gomez. Second serve once again. I don't believe it, Roscoe. He goes for an ace down the center. Serves his sixth double fault. It will change sides.
That's like, I mean, as soon as he's got it wrapped up, he opens the door.
That's incredible. Second serve.
I mean, I know hitting the net scared him a little bit on the serve, so he wanted to put a little more on it, make sure he cleared the net, but you don't have to serve it like it's a first serve.
Wow. Big chance by Gomez. Double faults. So Clerc now, right back in this tiebreak, 4-2 Gomez. He'll serve from the other side. Gomez is serving, though, except for that double fault, Roscoe, serving much better.
His rhythm and timing is much better. It looks to me like he's more relaxed about the serve, and so he's not mulling something over or thinking about something other than what he's doing. He's in the current. He's thinking about what he's actually doing now as opposed to the past. Still, though, there's only one break between them right now, one mini break.
Good. Yes. Perfect lob from Gomez right up the line.
It's in exactly the right place, too, because that's right over the backhand side of court. You can't really hit the ball very hard from there. And so it's a perfect placement for a lob.
So now Andres Gomez at championship point for the first time.
Clerc right down the center. Service ace.
So he's got two match points on his own serve.
11 aces for Clerc. They have all been timely.
Yep.
Yes, Gomez